Pocoyo?
Hello.
Oh. What's this?
Duh.
Yes. I wonder what's behind it. Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out?
Yes!
Open it!
A door to the sky? Now that's unusual. I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door!
Pato, there you are! Pocoyo is looking for you! Wait! Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him! Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again! Oh my, that is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him? Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear! Now, Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo.
Ellie!
Hello, Ellie!
Pato!
Hooray! You found him! What's that, Ellie? You're working on something? What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye. See you soon.
The Ball Orchestra's Party. Hello, everyone. What are you up to today? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt. Of course, it's the Ball Orchestra. What a wonderful visit. Oh my.
Party?
I don't know, Pocoyo. Maybe they're going to use the radio to play music. Oh. Maybe not.
Orchestra?
Has invited you to their party, but to find it, you must first figure out some clues. We'll keep you posted.
George.
I don't know, Pato. Perhaps the party is back there. You could have a look. That Pato has found the key to locate the party. Bravo! You have solved the first puzzle. This has been our broadcast for today. Stay tuned for more. Where is your musical note?
Peppa.
Cheer up, Pato. Remember, we're going to a party.
Party!
Peppa.
done. Great tune, Pocoyo. Come on, Ellie, make us dance. And one, and two, and three, and... That's it, Pato. Shake those feathers. You found another portal. Very good. You're getting closer to the party. Hey, guys. Hey, everyone. Shh. Do you hear that? Yes, it's the trumpet ball. The party must be very close by. Come on, we have to find it.
Uh-oh!
Hello, Fred.
Party?
Pocoyo is wondering if you know how to get to the Ball Orchestra's party. Great! Which way is it? I didn't get that either. Fred, are you sure? There should be only one way to get to a party. Oh, dear. It's working, Pocoyo. Keep playing, keep playing. You solved the last puzzle. Hooray for friends, and hooray for parties full of music and rhythm. Goodbye, see you soon. Excellent. Keep dancing like that.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
What shall we play today, Pocoyo? Yes, I see it too, Pocoyo. Something shiny. I'm not sure Pocoyo knows what that is. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what this is? Exactly, a key. And who knows what surprises it might unlock. How exciting. Yes, and you know, if I didn't know better, I'd say that was the kind of key they once used to open old pirates' treasure chests.
Treasure? Treasure! Treasure!
That's amazing. It looks like... It is a keyhole, Pocoyo.
Treasure?
Give it a try. Well, I don't know about treasure, but I've never seen anything like that before.
Hello. Treasure? Treasure! Treasure?
Well, there's no treasure here. Sorry for waking you, sleepy bird.
Key. Treasure. Treasure. Key. Treasure. Treasure. Treasure.
Hey, hey. Another keyhole. Ooh, I didn't realize we had a basement.
Treasure! Treasure! Treasure, treasure, treasure. Treasure! Battle!
Surprised to see us, Pato?
Treasure Pato!
Exciting. Go on, give it a try. Now they're on the bottom of the sea. Well, this looks like it's as far as you can go, doesn't it? I don't believe it. Look!
Treasure! Treasure!
You know, I think it just might be. Nothing would surprise me after what I've seen today. Go ahead, Pocoyo. Open it. I wonder what's inside. Sweets? Toys? What could the treasure be? What is it? What's there? Will all of you go and look and tell me what's in the treasure chest?
It's lots of keys!
Treasure!
This is the best treasure of all, isn't it? After the fun we've had today. Keep opening doors, asking questions, and exploring your world. That is the key to it all. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
What's going on?
Rocket.
Ah, you're making a rocket. Why? What's that, little alien? Oh, you're going back to your planet. Wonderful. Looks like they're ready for blast off.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition.
Wow! This is exciting!
Professor Potter.
Welcome to another lesson with Professor Pato. Now, class, pay attention. Today we're going to talk about space. This is the sun. The sun. And this is the moon. The moon. Planets. These are planets. And stars. Baby bird, can you tell us what that's called? Can you tell Baby Bird what those are?
Stars!
Those are stars!
Oh, it looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say. Wonderful! Now we've all learned about space.
Lesson approved by Professor Potter.
It, Pocoyo! You flew into space!
Stop! Planet?
What do you think? Is that a planet?
No! It is the sun!
You're right! That is the sun! You're going to drive, Pato? Oh, but...
Whoa!
That's not a planet, Pato. Can you tell Pato what that is?
The moon!
It's the moon!
Yes, it's the moon. Look, little alien, is that your planet? Yes, you've found it!
Houston, we have a problem.
It's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, run! That's it, run! Fred says, laugh! Come on, let's laugh! Says, dance! Let's dance! Fred says, that's all! Someone's knocking at the door. Oh, it's the little alien's parents. Oh, I see. It was just a game. But now it's time for the little alien to go home. Let's all say goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Looks like they're off on another mission.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rocket to the stars, searching for a planet, flying near the sun. To the stars, searching for a planet, flying near the sun.
When you are approaching a traffic signal. What an amazing race! They all deserve to. This is the last lap. Nothing is decided. Pato is in first place. Oops, you didn't brake in time and have lost control. Let go of the accelerator when you approach a traffic signal. What a. Hi, Pato. You're looking sharp. Have you got a new job? Oh, I see. You've become an outer space postman. How exciting. And you've got an assistant. Who is this package for, Pato? Ah, to Green Alien. And it's a rush delivery? Well, you'd better get going. You wouldn't want your first package to be delivered late. And we have liftoff! According to the address, Green Alien's house should be around here somewhere. Yep, here it is. Pato? I don't think that's him. Oh, I see. He says that Green Alien has moved and he doesn't live here anymore. But he would be happy to give you his new address. Well, according to this new address, Green Alien should be living right here. I'm afraid this is the wrong address. But no worries, the Toridoris know where he is. Looks like there's no one on this planet. I'm so sorry, Mr. Basketball. He says Green Alien's not here either, Pato, but that this is his new address. Yeah.
green alien. At last you found him. He's wondering what took you so long. Oh no! The Vamoosh is out of fuel. The sun will take you back home. Welcome home. Good job. Quite right. Baby Bird deserves some credit too. Hooray for Baby Bird! You took a perfect photo. Ah, off for an adventure in outer space.
Yay!
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato. What's that, Pato? You want to drive the Vamoosh? Oh dear, Pato! Can all of you tell Pato to be careful?
Be careful, Pato!
Maybe that piece wasn't very important. Then again, maybe it was. No. It looks as if you'll just have to find that missing piece of the Vamoosh.
That way.
It looks like Pato wants to search in the other direction, Pocoyo. What was that?
Go!
Pato heard a very strange sound, Pocoyo. Perhaps it was just your imagination, Pato. It wasn't your imagination at all. It's an alien. Pocoyo doesn't believe that Pato saw an alien. Let's all tell Pocoyo that we saw it too.
Yes! There really is an alien.
Pato! Pato!
Careful!
Can any of you tell Pocoyo where the alien is? It's the missing part of the Vamoosh. That's why he was chasing you, Pato. He only wanted to give it back. Watermelon? Your favourite, Pato! It looks as if you've made a very special friend, Pato. It's nearly nap time. Don't worry, Pato. You can visit your new friend another day. You only need to improve your driving skills just a tad. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for Pocoyo! And hooray for making new friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!
It seems like Pato has a solution. Shall we help him? Very good! You did it on the first try! What a great idea, Pato! With that giant broom, we will tidy everything up in no time. Bravo! You have collected all the blocks. Hello, Pocoyo.
I'm not Pocoyo. Super Inventor Pocoyo.
Oh, I see. You're a Super Inventor. Super Inventor Pocoyo.
Yay, yay.
show us any of your inventions?
Ta-da!
Wow! That's such a great gadget! What's it for? Oh, I see. It's broken.
Wait!
Oh! There you have another new device. What's this one for?
Not finished!
Pocoyo? I wonder if you might have any other inventions? Maybe one that is finished or works? Oh, okay, that way. Wow! That's amazing! A super invention! Whoa! It's a teletransporting machine! And would you give us a demonstration?
Pato!
Great! Pato, Pocoyo has built a machine and we'd love to try it. We were wondering whether you'd, well, if you'd like to help us. I see. This is another one of your gadgets. Incredible! It's a mind-reading machine. Reading Pato's mind, we'll find out if he wants to take part in this experiment.
Pato says yes!
I'm afraid we've run out of volunteers. Well done, Ellie! We've got our volunteer back! That's weird. He should have arrived by now. Oh no! The machine has a virus and Pato is stuck inside. We've got to help him get out. Caterpillar, we need to bail Pato out. As soon as Pocoyo signals us, we need to push this button and bring our friends back. Well done. We just need to find Pato now. But this world is huge. We're never going to find him. Oh, there he is. And the virus is after him. Run, Pato, run!
papyrus. It's fallen apart. Oh no! It's getting put back together. What do you mean, Pocoyo? Oh, it's time to signal Caterpillar. All right, I'll take care of it. Caterpillar, do you remember what Pocoyo explained before? Good. Now you need to push the button. No, no, focus, Caterpillar. This is really important. You must press the button. No, Caterpillar, not that button. You must trigger the red switch, the one marked with the arrow. No, Caterpillar, you need to focus. Come on, Caterpillar, the big button, the red one. That's right, Caterpillar, the red button. No, no, Caterpillar, you need to press the button. No? But Caterpillar, we need to bring our friends back. Phew! Just in time. This has been really exciting. Oh, the virus, it's still there. Well done! That's much better! Great! Now let's keep enjoying new adventures!
Hello, Pocoyo!
Hi!
I see that you've got a brand new toy. What is it, Pocoyo? Do any of you know what Pocoyo's new toy is?
It's a plane!
It's an aeroplane!
Yes, that's right!
Plane!
Oh, Pocoyo loves his new toy plane. I wonder why he loves it so much. Oh, I think he's going to show us why. It looks like Ellie wants a turn flying the plane. Do you know how to make it fly, Ellie? That's right, you wind it up. But don't wind it up too much, Ellie.
Uh-oh. Plane, no!
Look how high it's going. Oh, we've lost Pocoyo's plane. How can we find it if we can't even see it? A telescope. What a good idea, Pato. When you look through a telescope, you can see things that are far away. Quick, Pocoyo, look through the telescope. Thank you.
Well, it looks like the plane flew all the way up to outer space. How will we ever get up to outer space to get it back? Oh, of course, the Vamoosh.
Aliens. Don't be afraid.
Oh, what fun! But what about your toy plane, Pocoyo? Maybe the aliens know where it is.
Airplane.
I don't think you can reach it up there, Pocoyo. And nor can Ellie or Pato. Do you know anyone who could reach it, Pocoyo? I don't know. Maybe, or just maybe, someone very stretchy. Can any of you see someone who can stretch right up and help Pocoyo get his plane?
The alien!
Yay! Our new alien friend did it! Hooray! Oh, I think the aliens want to say something. Let's have a party.
Yay!
Terrific idea! By finding his plane, Pocoyo has found some new friends too. How splendid! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hi, Nina.
Hi.
Having a picnic, I see. Mmm, and something smells good.
Mmm.
Oh, cupcakes, Ellie. I bet you worked hard on them. They look marvelous. Well done. Oh dear, Ellie. And you worked so hard. No cupcakes today. What a pity. A machine that can take you backwards in time? Oh, so you can go back to before the cupcakes were smashed. Brilliant! But how's it work?
Thank you.
Incredible! We've gone back in time a whole minute. Guys, aren't you forgetting something important? No, Pocoyo, the banana peel. We can't let Ellie slip on it again. She's coming! Hurry! Tuck in. You ate them all. Oh, I see. You'll just go back in time again and have a second helping. But, oh dear, where are we? Yee-haw! We're in the Old West. But it looks like Miss Ellie isn't making cupcakes. Say that now we're in prehistoric times. Aha! The banana peel, of course. You're back in the present, and just in time for the cupcakes. Oh dear, hard luck, guys. You're a bit late. No, wait, there's Ellie. And she made more cupcakes just for you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Well, hello, baby bird.
Oh, my! What was that?
I see. Can any of you tell baby bird who that was?
It's Pocoyo and Patto!
You're right! It's Pocoyo and Patto. And it looks like they're out for a ride in the Vamoosh. What fun!
Bye.
Oh, I think Baby Bird wants to tell you something, Pocoyo. Baby Bird wants you to teach him to drive the Vamoosh, Pocoyo. Maybe if we all say please. Ready? Now. Please, Pocoyo. Please. Please let him. Please teach him.
Okay. After lunch.
Ah. Pocoyo will teach you to drive the Vamoosh after lunch, Baby Bird. I think Baby Bird is afraid you might forget, Pocoyo.
Promise.
I think Baby Bird is ready for you to teach him now, Pocoyo.
After play.
But you said after lunch, Pocoyo. Okay. Now, Pocoyo?
Later.
I know, Baby Bird. This really isn't fair. After all, Pocoyo promised. Now, Baby Bird, I don't think you should be messing about with the Vamoosh before Pocoyo has an opportunity to... Oh, heavens! Baby Bird! I can't look. No, I can't watch. Oh, no! Oh, Ellie, wake up, Ellie. Oh, dear. Oh, not again. However are you going to save Baby Bird? Pato wants you to push that big button, Baby Bird. Ah, excellent. Good work, Pato. Now, everyone, I know you're upset with Baby Bird, but it's not entirely his fault. After all, Pocoyo, you made him a promise. Can any of you remind Pocoyo what he promised Baby Bird?
He promised to teach him to drive the Vamoosh.
Yes, that's right. You did, Pocoyo, you know. You did. You promised.
Okay.
That's bad. later. Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for keeping promises. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Pocoyo is going to have lots of fun today. He's off to play with his friend Pato. What's this? I think it's a shadow. Yes, that shadow seems to be following you, Pocoyo. What could be making the shadow? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what's making the shadow? Yes, it's a little cloud. I wonder where he came from. There's Pato. Perhaps he can help. Yes, well, not so funny now, is it, Pato? Oh, Pato doesn't like the cloud either. The little cloud is crying.
Clouds cry?
How strange. If I didn't know better, I'd think, yes, it's true. The cloud's feelings are hurt. I wonder, what will you do now, Pocoyo? You've got an idea. What is it? Oh, I see. You want to talk to the cloud. That's a wonderful idea, Pocoyo, but I'm not sure the cloud can hear you.
Shout!
Terrific idea, Pocoyo. If you all shout together, the little cloud will be able to hear you.
Cloud!
Cloud!
Yes, it worked! I think the little cloud likes you, Pocoyo. I think perhaps, could it be? Yes, I think this little cloud just wants a friend.
Friend.
Pocoyo, cloud. Friends?
Friends.
I think the cloud would like to give his two new friends a ride. That means you too, Pato. What fun! There's Lula! And there's Ellie! Look, Ellie! Pocoyo and Pato have made a friend! Just as I always say, nothing brightens up your day like making a new friend. Hooray for Pocoyo! See you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo! Can anyone tell me what Pocoyo is playing with?
Blocks!
Blocks? No, no, no. I think what Pocoyo is playing with are... Oh, my. Well, yes, they are blocks after all. Well, blocks are fun to play with, too. Very good! Look, everyone! Hasn't Pocoyo built a lovely tall...
clock!
What? That's odd. Where'd that clock come from? That's a great idea. A nice nap in the cool shadow of a magnificent leafy
tree.
It all looks very tasty, Pocoyo. Perhaps a snack will do. So, are you going to make a sandwich? Good idea! First, he starts with a slice of...
bread!
Next, a slice of...
cheese!
Oh, yummy, Pocoyo! You've made a delicious...
bundle!
Well, that's nice. If you can't eat your sandwich, at least you can play the banjo.
Slide.
Yes, there's nothing more fun than playing on a...
Three.
Three. I agree, Pocoyo. Let's get to the bottom of this mess.
Bye!
Oh, now I understand. Nina is playing magic words.
Barry.
Oh, very good, Pocoyo. A party. Something's missing. Bye-bye! Space Holidays. Look, it's Ellie. Hello, Ellie. Where are you going with that big backpack? Oh, you're going on vacation. That's wonderful. Now. What seems to be the problem?
Mountain.
Oh, I see. Pocoyo wants to go on vacation to the mountains. Ah, I understand. It seems like Pato would rather go to the beach. Well, they're both fantastic options. We'll have a great time wherever we go. You'll see. Just a moment. I think Ellie has an idea. Space vacation? That sounds like fun, doesn't it? Doesn't it? I'm not sure that Pocoyo and Pato like your idea very much, Ellie. Come on, you two. Trust Ellie. She knows all the best spots in the universe. First stop, the planet of the bubble craters. How exciting. Oh. Wow. Ellie, this place is incredible. Oh dear, Pato doesn't seem to like this planet.
Boring.
Oh no, not again! You're right, Ellie. I'm sure they'll like the next planet we visit more than this one.
Welcome to the planet of the musical trees.
Whoa! What rhythm, Ellie? don't think Pocoyo is in the mood for dancing. Good idea, Ellie. Let's show them that this planet is amazing. Oh, ah, oh. Oh dear. Poor Ellie. This isn't turning out to be the most relaxing vacation. Last stop, everyone! It's incredible! Look! A beach in space!
Oh, look!
Wow! And that looks like a mountain! It's the best planet in outer space. It has everything. The beach and the mountain.
Hey, yeah!
Ellie, this is a wonderful place.
Thank you, Ellie.
Wonderful! Now, everyone is going to enjoy their vacation. Ah, this is the life. Fantastic! Hooray for vacation and hooray for friends! Goodbye, see you soon!
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hi, Ellie. Hola, Pato. What's that sound? Oh, I see. Pato has set his alarm. That's odd. Packing? Where are you off to, Pato? You're going to visit your friends, Fred and Whale, underwater. What fun! Good idea. You'll need those where you're going. You're wondering what Pato is up to, right? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and Ellie where Pato is going?
To visit Whale and Octopus.
He's going underwater.
Bye, Pato. Have fun. Playing with friends underwater. What could be more fun? What's this? A ball! Great! You're going to play catch! Ow. It's hard to play catch underwater. Oh my! All of your toys are floating away. What are you going to play with? Ah, your trumpet. Now this should be fun. Oh dear. Apparently, trumpets and water don't mix. Ah, now here's something you can enjoy. A comic book. Oh dear, it's ruined. Pato? dear. Being underwater even puts a damper on your tantrum. I'm afraid Pato isn't having as much fun as he expected to.
Ah.
Ah, nothing like a nice meal to cheer you up, right, Pato? Woohoo! That certainly is an interesting dish. Seaweed spaghetti, is it? Pato wants to know if you'd like to eat some.
No!
No way!
You eat it!
No, me? No! Oh, no, no, no. I ate earlier. I think you'll have to tuck in, Pato. Good work, Pato. Oh dear, you're not leaving, are you, Pato? Is it because none of your toys worked? And you don't like the food here? I suppose you're missing home. Looks like Whale is going to give you a ride before you leave. Just to show you how much fun being underwater can be. Kind of fun, isn't it? There's something else Whale would like to show you before you go, Pato. A bubble. That. You can play ball in there, just like at home. What's this? Sponges. A sponge trampoline. What fun! It looks as if Pato is having a really great time. What do you think? Does Pato like it underwater after all? This? A giant shell? What's inside?
Yeah.
It's Pocoyo and Emmy! Hooray for getting used to new things! And hooray for fishy friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!